US importer stores a shipment of imported shoelaces in another company's warehouse in California and later ships it to Argentina. So E, no transfer. When you store it at another company's warehouse, you simply buy a storage space. You pay your fees to store the product, the commodity, but you are not transferring the title. So the title remains with the US importer, which later send it out to Argentina. There was no transfer of title. So, and we're looking for the one that's not required, does not require 7552, does not require a transfer, making E a correct answer choice over here. All others had transfer to a different legal entity, to a different company, which initiates the requirement for the chain of custody records. All right. Certificate of manufacture of delivery also reported on 7552. So instead of checking certificate of delivery, you would check the certificate of manufacture and delivery box. It must be prepared, of course, by manufacturer and producer. And here I make a note that the Trade Facilitation and Trade Enforcement Act done away with this document, with this form, and it simply requires documents that are ordinarily kept in the regular course of business. All right, so here is another reproduction of the form. It can be, again, it's to document the transfer itself, and it can be used for imported substitution and interchangeable merchandise. All right, so here is one example of the form itself being tested. The company A imports screws, the imported screws are sold to company B, which uses the screws to manufacture tables. Company B exports tables to Spain, which form must company A use? So here it's a straightforward 7552. In case you're not familiar, this is an importer of record input. So if you're the first time user, you must put your name and address into the customs system, and this is a form you use. 7553 is a notice of exportation and destruction. 7514 is a FTZ transfer. If you're transferring, not exporting, but transferring the merchandise for which you will claim drawback into the foreign trade zone, this is a form you use. And 4811, we discussed this before, this is a form that you use for to make sure that bills and notices are going to a party, to a different party, not the importer of record party. So 7522B is correct response. So purpose, we talked about purpose, transfer, identify, and assignment of drawback rights. Exam question. Company A imports widgets and then sells it to company B. Company B exports widgets and is now filing unused merchandise drawback. Which document is required? Document transfer assign rights and identify widgets. And it's 7512, certificate of delivery, right? Even though certificate of manufacturer's delivery is done in the same form, we have no manufacturer. We have unused merchandise drawback, so certificate of delivery is the same. Now, trade-off is 1313K. This is a provision which has been changed. It's still on the books as far as the regulations is concerned, but the Trade Enforcement and Trade Facilitation Act changed that. So let me pull. Let me pull up the informed compliance publication, because I think it provides a good summary of what trade-off really is. And it's reminiscent to the manufacturing drawback claim, except when there is a transfer, a certificate of delivery is not required. Of course, Trade Facilitation Trade Enforcement Act done away with certificate of delivery, right? So we the provisions are no longer relevant. So they have been amended. And they have been amended to assign the responsibility, as we shall see in a bit. So the trade-off is that domestic merchandise acquired in exchange for imported merchandise it may be designated as imported merchandise, so you have a substitution taking place. And no certificate of delivery is issued with respect to the imported merchandise exchanged for domestic merchandise. So it's a provision which allows you to do away with a chain of custody used to be required document, which is no longer required. On a statutory level, we know that this was section 1313K. So if we go to our United States Code provisions, and of course the drawback statute is 1313. We see that, and if we pull it up, we see that the paragraph K, which is here, deals with something which is not which is not something which is described as a trade-off, right? It talks about liability, right? Any person making a claim for drawback shall be liable. Liability of importers and deals with joint and several liability, right? So it deals with passing with who gets the blame for something which went wrong in the context of drawback. All right. So what happened? And if you look at the legislative history here, and legislative history is provided way at the bottom. Prior provisions, right? This is a provision for the old provision. Which has been amended by subsection K, which has been amended by Trade Enforcement and Trade Facilitation Act of 2015, we also known as Public Law 114-125. We see that it used to say, right, prior to amendment, the text read as follows, right? For the purposes of A and B, which talks about the manufacturing drawback, the U 1313 A and B, the use of any domestic merchandise acquired in exchange for imported merchandise of the same kind of quality shall be treated as use for such if no certificate of delivery is issued to the respect, right? So no certificate of delivery, in other words, we saw that in the informed compliance publication, that it does away with the certificate of delivery chain of custody requirement. That is gone because certificate of delivery is no longer a requirement under this new provision of the law. So it's pretty much took the whole subsection and just changed it into the liability provision. So that's what's happening here. The regulations are still, as of the date of this lecture, they're still out there. So, and customs still have a tendency to test on all stuff, so I need to throw it out there. Customs, so keep in mind that those are the pointers. It must be manufacturing drawback, no certificate of delivery, and use of domestic product in exchange for imported merchandise of the same kind of quality. So as long as you keep those in mind and it shows up, you'll be well equipped to tackle this. You just need to put together the fact pattern understand that we're talking about the trade-off as it used to be defined under 1313K. To comply with manufacturing drawback, direct identification and substitution, the use of domestic merchandise taken in exchange for imported merchandise. So you have domestic merchandise exchanged for imported merchandise of the same kind of quality shall be treated as the use of imported merchandise if no certificate of delivery, right, is issued covering the transfer of imported merchandise. So this provision is known as trade-off, right? So trade-off. So the regulation is still out there. If we take a look at the regulation at 191 provisions, it's 191.11. It's still out there. So it hasn't been changed as of the date of this latest update. So be mindful of that. Now, so that's a little speech about trade-off. Moving on, certification waiving the right to drawback. So we talked about this a bit in the context of the 7552, where that one document does establish the assignment rights, and assignment rights may waive may act as a waiver to claim drawback for that particular party. Now, this particular chart is going to who is entitled to claim the drawback, and we already know that by looking at the chart at the earlier part of this discussion, we already know that it's either exporter or destroyer. In the derivatives, oil petroleum derivatives, the refiner is added. But pretty much exporter or destroyer is the common theme here. So to see that who is entitled without more to claim the drawback, we have to kind of refer to the buzzword, and this question here makes this chart very useful. The blank of record is entitled to claim the drawback. So we know it must be either destroyer or manufacturer, right? So we don't have a destroyer here listed here, right? Destroyer or the exporter, I'm sorry. But we have the exporter listed here. So the exporter here, because it is found everywhere, is the default party, again. So this is one of the ways customs examiners can test on this. And this succinct chart, we have a chart at the beginning that provides, that is more extensive. This chart is more succinct, so it may be more useful to answer questions like this. Assignment of drawback claimants. Assigned drawback claimants. So when you make an assignment, the assignment is done through certification, which waives the right to claim drawback and assigns the right to claim drawback to various parties. And it makes the affirmation that the drawback is not assigned to anyone. We've seen this where? We've seen this already in 181.82, right? Person entitled to claim drawback. So we've seen that this should be affirmation that there will be no assignment. There should be certification waiving the right to claim drawback, right? And we saw those assignment provisions going to that certificate of delivery form 7552. Now, of course, now since you have documents that are kept in a regular course of business requirement, you can do this in the form of certification pursuant to 191.82 provision. All right. Going back to this to this point. Let's take a look at the question which comes up next on the which came up on the exam previously. So you have company ABC, and that's the importer. Imports shoes from Italy on June 2nd, 2011. Company ABC sells the shoes to company 123 in the United States in June 13, 2011. So we're having an unused merchandise drawback, right? Because company A123 doesn't do anything in the exports of shoes. What must company ABC obtain in order to claim drawback? So we know the default party is an exporter. Exporter here is company 123. Company ABC is the importer. So it must have some kind of document that allows, that says that company 123 is not in the game anymore. In other words, it must get one of those things or all of those things that I described in 190-192 waiver, certification or waiving the claim drawback, affirmation that there will be no assignment. All right, so those are the answer choices, right? Certificate of manufacture from the exporter. No, there was no manufacturing taking place. Letter of credit. No, this is not a commercial banking question, and this is not the shipping documentation question. Notice of intent to export from the exporter. No, that's the 123 company that has to do that. Certificate of delivery from the exporter. Well, that is the possibility, as long as it establishes the right. We talked about that. This is more precise. Certification from the exporter waiving the right to drawback. This is more precise and to the point because it is mentioned here. Certification shall affirm that the exporter will not assign the right to claim drawback, and certification waiving the right to claim drawback if the party is not the exporter, right? Right, unless. So waiver of the right to claim drawback is a must, and it is more to the point over here. So making E a correct answer, even though if you look really close, certificate of delivery from the exporter can also be the document which can be used to make that assignment. The similar question. Just like if you look almost verbatim, except if instead of company ABC you have company A, and instead of company 123 you have company B, on a different customs broker exam, customs asked pretty much the same thing. You have the company A, which is the importer who wants to claim drawback on the shoes, right, which were taken to Germany. And the same factor, same fact pattern as above, different exam question. You have custom examiners asking what is required for the company to have that ability. So just like the question above, E is the correct answer choice because it is more responsive to the question asked. Although certificate of delivery is also a possibility because it can be used as an operative document which establishes the assignment right, not only the chain of custody. Alright, so let's see. Alright, we are out of time at this point. So let's call it a day. And let's start at this submitting additional information required portion next class.